My full name is Samuel Tan Mala. I'm known more as Samuel.
Pastor Samuel, would you tell where do you work and what do you work right now?
Yes, at the moment I'm working as a pastor for the Hope Adventist, which is made up of Zombie, Korean, Burmese, and other ethnic groups in Indianapolis, Indiana State. So I work as a pastor there for the Indiana Conference. At the same time, I also work for the ASAP Ministries here in the US. And I also work for the North American Division of the Adventist Refugees and Immigrant Ministries to help with the Zombie, the Chin, dialect groups, and also with the Burmese government.
Would you share a little bit of, now we are at the youth camp, would you share a little bit of how it happened and you know, the knowledge you know about this camp, please?
Yes. Last year, when we had the Zombie Convention in Orlando, Florida, you know, we had a social day for the youth. And, you know, we had a great time getting to know each other, you know, not just superficial, knowing each other better. And, you know, we said, you know, we can do more than this. Why don't we have a gathering where we can encourage each other in our faith, know each other better, build friendship, maybe more. So we thought about it and also we decided, why don't we pray together? So we had a prayer and throughout this past 1 year, we had time to brainstorm together, pray together. And I'm so happy. I'm so happy because our God comes to heart of our teaching power, teaching power. You know, God impressed his heart to, you know, kind of help me and kind of act as a coordinator for this youth event. And God also touched the heart of our Zombie pastors and also the elders, the youth leaders. So all the youth leaders, all the pastors, we had that conference on a regular basis to make sure everything has been laid out, to make sure that things are prepared, to make sure that, you know, we have not just a gathering, but a spiritual revival gathering. So I'm happy, I'm very excited actually to see what's happening.
How would you say, like, I think we want to do it next year and in the future? Is there any suggestions to how better it or anything like what we can do since we're near the end of this year?
I would say in the future, it would be good if we can integrate the element of testimony. Yes. If we can have maybe like two youth that share personal testimony from their life or how Christ changed their lives and how they are not living a life that is filled with Christ as their center, as the head of their life. So, you know, this kind of life stories, life testimonies will really empower and strengthen our youth to take the initial step, you know, to move bravely forward. That would be one of my
prayers. I believe you're saying that this can come out of you getting together to praise. As these camps come out of prayer.
Praise,
so
yes.
I believe that that what you say was possible, very possible that it could happen, that you people, you know, share a lot of testimony.
Yes. And I believe with all my heart that by God's grace, this is not the first and the last Zombie. This is the first to the many Zombie.
Amen.
Then for like the testimony, that's it for personal experience. Sometimes I feel like my story is like in fear too. It's not like nothing. It's kind of like compared to other people. It's not as big a deal. It's not that much. So how would you, it's for me and for other people, how could you like encourage them to test out more?
Yes, I mean, in God's sight, everyone is equal. So even if you feel like your story is not as great, as exciting as the others, it doesn't mean that your story is not as important as the others. Your story is very important. And there are others that will be in the same shoes and they will understand your story better than other people's testimonies. So because you don't share, then there will be others that will understand your story and feel the same way and be spiritually revived will not have that opportunity. So that's why it's important that you share your story. Even if you think it's not important, even if you think it's not as exciting, as miraculous as can be, but still, it
if some youth, Adventist youth from United States could not come this time, do you have any message, a special message out of this camp for them?
Yes. Let's plan for next time for them to come. If they have to take vacation, let's prepare to take vacation. If they have things that they need, maybe either support from their local church or local conference, let us know. We will write letters, we will make phone calls for them, and then we'll try to find a way. Money should not stop any youth from coming to this youth. It is for every youth, young and old. So we want them to come next time if they miss this time. And besides, if they miss this time, we have recorded the videos. We can, watch the videos. And if there are questions, you can always ask T.G. Bao, myself, or Dr. Dong, or to you, to you guys. They can always ask.
Could you ask?
Is there any way that you can help out with your ministry, like what you're doing? Is there any way we can volunteer to help out other people?
Yes, we have many individuals, many youth that are interested to know more about God. So we need people, wherever you are, we need people to take part in sharing the Bible. Like during the summertime, many would like to come to Indianapolis to learn how to give Bible studies and to give Bible studies. Please come. I'm sure you can do the same thing in Tulsa. I'm sure you can do the same thing in Guyon, in Battle Creek, in Grand Rapids. In Indianapolis for this year, Iowa Missouri Conference President sent one of the pastors, Carl Smith, to come and work with us at the Indianapolis. And he is so kind to come, and he spent a few months during the summertime working together with him. He took part in giving our studies to Zoe families and other families with me. And we can do the same thing for other Zoe youth that want to share the Bible, give testimonies, preach in our church. Anyone is welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now we are watching, you are watching the interview with Pastor Samuel Tang, and this is the youth camp of the Zombie in the United States, and this is the first time. We do not hope this is the first, this is the last. We are expecting a whole lot more. And would you please, for the conclusion, would you please share maybe one or two words or sentence for all the youth people, all the people around, our relative friends?
Number one, always remember that you are very precious and important to God. Number two, value yourself. You are bought with Christ's blood, and you are worth more than any junk in the world. And number three, Christ is coming soon.
Amen.
And He wants to use you. He wants to bless you. He wants you to be happy. He wants you to be peaceful. He wants you to have the joy that no one can take away from you.
Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you.